I love the way, because people always think they can say anything to fat people anyway. Like, you know, like people ask me, "Well, you lost weight, but what was your favorite restaurant?" I said, "I used to love the Golden Corral, boy."
What?
I used to love the Golden Corral. I like going early before them, all them damn people with them badass kids come up in there. You know, kids come up there and mess up a buffet. Little boy, I was in there one time, then, right after church, little some bitch standing right at the mac and cheese. He ain't by the sneeze guard, so he right there sneezed right in the mac and cheese. Achoo! I fucked his ass up with that spoon. Pack out! Yeah, mac and cheese running all down his face. And I said, "That'll teach you to cover your damn mouth." And I put some mac and cheese on my plate. It was hot. It probably burnt all the bacteria. I like the Golden Corral, but people think they can say anything. I'm going in the Golden Corral one day. The dude ran right past. "Woo! Let me get in front of you." "I know you about to wreck this place, ain't you? It's about to be apocalyptic up in that son of a bitch. I was driving in the parking lot. I seen your big ass slide towards the door. I said, 'Please, Heavenly Father, just let me find a parking space anywhere, Lord, so I can just get one plate, Jesus. If it's your will.' So I just parked illegally and ran in front of you. Thank God you had on flip-flops. I would have never made it." And they mean in the Golden Corral. They mean as hell in the Golden Corral. I go in the Golden Corral. I want some dark meat chicken. I walk in the dark meat chicken. Young lady says, "Excuse me, when you gonna bring any more dark meat chicken out?" Look at her, I'm talking about, "When you leave." Disrespectfully. And the manager never say nothing to nobody. He gonna have the nerve to say something to me. He gonna have the nerve to say something to me. He gonna come up to me and tap me on the shoulder while I'm enjoying my meal. "Hey, big man, just let you know, we close at 9:30. Well, I don't know why you telling me that. It ain't nothing but 12 noon. "It's like I said, bruh, we close at 9:30. All right. I'll be out here by 8:45. That's what you said yesterday, and I had to play my employee time and a half. You better be out here by 8:45. I'ma call the police." I had to get the hell out of there. I ain't wanna be. That's been embarrassing to get arrested going out of Gold Corral. What'd he do? He asked for more dark meat. And I love to go and Corral, but my mom always wanna tag along. My mom here. She came down to San Antonio to support me. I love my mama. That's my girl. she been there all the time. But she always wanna go to Golden Corral with me. And my mama is a racist. A racist against fat people. For real, she is. And she lost a lot of weight. She's beautiful, but she's still thick, you know. But she hard on fat folk. We can't even enjoy our meal. She's talking about every fat person coming to the door. I'm talking about. "Look, but don't look." And then you're like, "Big ass, no, she don't need to be up in here. Big ass sliding across the floor with them ballerina shoes on. Lord, what ballet is her big ass at? Sliding past the salads to the fudge, to the chicken, to the fudge. She putting fudge on her damn chicken. This child here, Lord have mercy. And got her to have one of them pink Victoria's Secret pink jogging suits. It's supposed to say pink on the back of the pants, but the I and the N in the crack of her ass. All it say is p-cack." And that's the noise it's gonna make when she try to get the I and the N out the crack of her ass. P-cack. My wife beautiful, but women are vindictive, you know. They vindictive. My wife had the audacity to record me snoring on her iPhone. Talking about, press play and watch this. I press play, I'm on there snoring like this. I sound like a Biggie record. Baby, baby! And that ain't even the worst part. My son, he's a beautiful boy, but he just like me. He's mini me. He sleep in the bed with us. Sometimes he be on one side of the bed, I'm on the other side. He on the other side. I'm like, I can't take this shit no more. I said, go write your letter somewhere. Because every man in here can attest to this with your wife or your girlfriend. No, you're tired. All we've done is do this. Like, baby, baby, wake up. What's wrong? What's wrong? You're snoring. That's what you're supposed to do when you sleep. That's how you know I'm alive. If you don't hear, call an ambulance. Some bad shit going down. And one night I went to sleep before my wife. I got in bed before I went to sleep before, and I was in the bed. I'm like, ooh, baby, lay on your stomach. You're snoring. I said, okay. Oh shit, you farting. Lay back on your back. Shit, lay on your side. Oh shit, I can't take either noise. I'm gonna go sleep in the car. Now, I know I ain't the only one farting they sleep. Anybody else here farting they sleep? It happens. No control. You ever fart in your sleep and wake yourself up? Hello, who's in there? I can smell you, and I can hear you. Show your stinking self. And I must fart a lot in my sleep because my wife be trying to get revenge on me. I know she's trying to get revenge because she sleep with her ass up on the pillow by my face. But she fart entirely too hard to be asleep. I said, open your damn eyes, open your eyes. Ain't no way you can fart like that and be asleep. You asleep and your muscles were relaxed. I had to go get my whole body re-skinned and burnt. We had to burn these pillowcases and give Junior 2, 3, or 4 chemical baths. See, I got a good one, man. We, like I said, we fight each other, but we fight more to stay together, and that's a beautiful thing, you know. But my wife, sometimes she give me some special, she do something special for me. Like, you know, one time I came home back when I was a lot bigger. She surprised me, right, you know? Surprised me. She had a little necklace on, looking sexy as hell. You know, standing at the door, said, come with me. And I followed her into the bathroom. She had rose petals all over the floor. And said she had candles all around the tub. And she had a little Luther Vandross playing. It was real romantic in there. Yeah, it was like, what are we about to do? We bought her a steamer. She said, we about to take a bath together. I was like, oh, shit, all right. I ain't really a bath kind of brother, you know. I do showers. I don't fuck with that tub. It's, you know, but for that booty, I do it. You know what I'm saying? All right, let me figure this out. She had skin so soft all in the tub. Some people don't know what skin sauce is. That's black people bug repellent, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, make your skin supple, you understand? If you ain't got nothing, get you some, you know? So she had put that all in the tub, and she said, okay, baby. She took her clothes off, and she got in the tub. She said, I'm gonna get in the tub, you get in with me. I said, you get in first, boo. So she got in like a little pebble, doink. And she said, okay, you get in now. I said, all right, I took my time. I put one foot in like the hokey pokey, and I took it out. I put the foot back in, and I gingerly put that other leg in. And as I lifted my leg up, But that nigga, I gingerly put it in. But when I set the foot down, I must have stepped on something that skin so soft. Cause my foot just slipped from under me. I went up in the air and hit that water like boom. I hit that water tsunami. That's all I'm gonna tell you. Washed all the rope bands and ambiance out of the tub. My wife left on a tidal wave. I don't know where she was. All I heard was, I'm naked in the street. Wasn't no water left in the tub, and it was plenty of skin so soft, and I couldn't get out of the damn tub for shit. I'm spinning around in something like this. I'm like, oh my God, like my wife naked in the street. I couldn't get out for shit. Finally, I had to push my belly up on the tub and ooze out like melted caramel. And I still couldn't stand up because I was slippery and supple, so I had to inch across the floor like a fat caterpillar just. Finally made it to the carpet. I was able to get some grip on the carpet. And I laid down, but all the carpet had laid up on my chest. Looked like I had a bra on and it was in my crotch too. Looked like I had a two-piece furry bikini on. Told my wife, you can't do that shit no more. Watching Facebook, and I find out I ain't black enough. Cause they be showing so many brothers getting messed up by the police. I mean, the police grabbing and throwing them out of the car. We need to share this, brother. Let them know how they doing us out here. And I'm like, damn, that's terrible. But every time you turn around, it's another brother getting choked. Another brother getting choked. I'm like, damn, I mean, that's a lot of chokings. And I want to march, but I want to find out, did y'all edit this shit? We don't know exactly what happened. We get over mad. We got to find out, because, you know, cops are mean. They can be mean, but most of the time, if you chill out, they usually say, here's your ticket and get your black ass out of here. Yeah. It don't never be over that, you know, but they don't never show the brother, you know, snapping off. Motherfucker, I know my right. You ain't gonna do me like this. You know, officer, what the fuck you doing, damn pig? Always fucking with black people, see? That shit gonna get you fucked up. I'ma just share something with my young black brother, because older black brother know. Angry black Negro, all we get is pepper spray, tase, and shot. Anytime you snap off, you get pepper spray, tased and shot. I'm a lawyer. Pepper spray, tased and shot. I pay my taxes. Pepper spray, tased and shot. I'm President Obama. Pepper spray, tased and shot. The best thing is shut your ass up, get your ticket and go about your damn business. Always trying to be the hood cat, always trying to be the man, trying to show off to the police. Okay, all right. I was with my cousin one day. He a so-called, quote-unquote, real nigga. He's a real nigga, you know. And I was in the car when the police pulled up on him. My cousin goes, don't worry about it, cuz. I'm finna handle this punk-ass pig. What'd you say? Watch this, cuz. I'm finna handle this shit. I said, okay. When that cop started walking out of that car, I went in instant survival mode. Only thing I can do is go special needs on his ass. And the police came up flashing like, what's wrong with your boy over there? My cousin, he didn't know I went into special needs mode on him. He looked. I'm right here. He said, I don't know. And in the midst of him handling this business with the police, I special need my way out of that seatbelt. And I special need all the way back to this police car, and I set the hell down. The police came down, what the hell are you doing in my car? I said, hi, sir. I ain't special needs for real, but I am riding in the car with a real nigga. That's what he said he was, a real nigga. I don't know what type of nigga I am, but I know I'm not a real nigga, sir. He said he about to handle you, he about to check you or something. And I know this gonna lead to being pepper sprayed and shot and tased also. And I'ma just say this, I love hot sauce on my fish and chicken. And I love electricity going through my house and charging up my phone, not going through my body, make me flip like a catfish. And I don't like lead at all. So after you get done doing that to him, I'm gonna need a ride home. I don't got time to prove nothing to nobody. Police pull me over. I'm okay. You can judge me if you want to, but police pull me over. I ain't no real nigga. I'm Uncle Tommy like a motherfucker. Police pull me over. I'm in that car just like this. Woo!
Hi, sir. I'm so thankful you pulled me over, sir. It's a blessing that you pulled me over, because I was out here like, Lord, oh, Lord, what am I doing in Jasper, Texas, this late, Lord? Lord, what I'm doing over here, Jesus, I'm so thankful Officer Cunningham was able to pull me over and pull me in the right direction. It's so late, too. It's 1 o'clock in the afternoon. It's too late to be out here like that. I told my wife, what we doing out here this late? You said, I got a tail light out. God bless you, sir, because you an expert. I ain't even know my tail light was on. God bless you, sir. Bless you, sir. I got a headlight out. I don't even have them on. How you know they out? Thank you, sir. Bless you, Jesus. Bless you. Can I pray with you? Heavenly Father, just please get this wonderful officer, Officer Cunningham, safe out here, protecting people like myself, keeping me and my wife and kids safe from harm and danger, Jesus. Get him home to his family, Jesus. These words of Christ pray, amen. You take care, sir. God bless you. Soon as he pulled off, though, I Tupac, Nat Turner, Ice Cube like my pussy-ass, bitch-ass cop, punk motherfucker. Swear to God, you know how I do. If that bitch-ass nigga didn't know no better, I'd have reached in my glove compartment, got my Glock out, it'd be another story up in this bitch. Click, click, bang, bitch. Click, click, bang, bitch-ass fuck ass pig, fuck all them old pussy ass police out there. I'm a nut, bitch. Whew. Oh, I ain't see you there, officer. I ain't know you came back. We were just about to get out of here, sir. Oh, you give me the ticket when I have my seatbelt on. God bless you. Can I pray with you again? Your friends ain't your damn friend, and they don't tell your ass you're big. Big girls are beautiful. Well, you're beautiful in your own way. Just don't be trying to. Yeah, you can clap for yourself. Big men are beautiful. Shit, big men clap for yourself. Shit. Ain't no shame in the game. Don't be ashamed. You can get a woman. Big man get a girl just like a little man. Little man just work out. Big man gonna be there when she come back from working out. You always want a man around. You got a round man that's around. But look, you know, big girls get mad, but I just, what bothers me about big girls, they always trying to hang with their skinny friends, going shopping with their skinny friends shop. Your skinny friends shop there don't mean you guys shop there. I mean, you just trying to follow the leader. You be your own leader. You know, she got her store, you got your store. But when your ass walking up in Forever 21, and you know you can't fit much in that something, bitch. When you walking through the aisles and shit sticking to your ass, and you ain't picked it up, you don't supposed to be in there. But your friend ain't telling your ass the truth. Got on some damn leggings, ass out the back like it's working security. Ass looking all in the back of it. Shoulders big as mine, got on a halter top. And it's a belly top, both her belly buttons sticking out. And she turned around to her skinny friend, and if she ain't no real friend, you know she ain't gonna turn, girl, is this cute? And your skinny friend look at you, she, yeah, I was in the store, I saw this, I was with my wife, she a petite woman, we was in the store, she was over there shopping, I seen this shit went down. The skinny girl looked at her fat friend, said, yeah, girl, that's real cute, girl, that's real cute, but what make that really cute? And then she stepped on another level, gonna talk about, what would make that really cute? You put this chain belt around your belly button. That's when I stepped in, no, bitch, no! She is not your fucking friend. She is a lying whore. That does not look good on you. Don't you dare put that chain belt around your belly button. Make it look like your stomach's in a penitentiary. And you get out of them leggings. Them are not, you need asses. It's not covering your ass. And that's a halter top. The key word of that is halt. And put that shit back on the rack. Get your big ass out of here. This is not your store, this is Forever 21. Forever 42 is down the street. And I told that joke earlier in the night. And I'm you know, I ain't never here to make you love me. I make you laugh. Sometimes you have a critic. And as soon as I told that joke, this, I guess, the national president of big girls. She stood up, excuse me, Mr. Carr, I don't give a shit if this is your little taping, but for your information, Forever 21 has a plus section now. And I looked at her and I said, you mean tell me you're gonna get your ass up to fuck up my show? You tell me you ain't got a plus section, well, let me let you in on session. Yeah, they may have a plus section, but when I look at you, they need a multiplication section.
I gotta give y'all a dab. I'm up in the Alamo. I know this is where the first win. White people lost bad up here. There should be more black folks. The black folks ran out of, I don't know if it was Mexican or whatever. They say it's Mexican, but white folks ran the hell out of Alamo. I love white folk, but that's where they had to go. All right, we done, we good, thank you. I like San Antonio, this is a badass city, man. I should have did all my damn specials here. I already had championship basketball teams all the time. Yeah, y'all was winning a lot till everybody got old. Yeah, but everybody got old, you know. Tim Duncan, he good. That back got bad. He was like, I'ma wrap it up. Yeah. But y'all was kicking ass. Y'all had a dynasty down here. I was like, damn. Yeah, man. I live in Texas myself. I live in Houston now. I moved to Houston, man. I know a little bit about it down here. I know one thing, y'all, U-turns are some bullshit. I tell ya. I swear to God, I ain't never, GPS can't even work down here. We got GPS like, hold on. Go back around, dog. I think we missed it. Let me, pull over. I ain't never heard of GPS say pull over. What kind of bullshit? And if you miss your turn, you gotta go all the way to Abilene. Make a left at El Paso and come back around. And nobody know how to get nowhere around this son of a bitch. I get down the street, this street, down what street? I'm like, oh shit, you don't know your way around. Well, just go around the U-turn and come back around. See, I like this part of Texas because in Houston, they don't have the quick trip. Yeah, that quick trip off the chain. Y'all know about that quick trip? Some of y'all don't know nothing about it. It's a gas station, but it got a hot dog bar. Yeah. You can put everything in there on that hot dog bar. It's like they have peppers, onions. And you look at that hot dog, you know how long before they're ready. And it's always a hot dog chef. Six more turns. All right, I'm counting to one, two. I forgot I got some gas. Oh, shit, give me 5 on 10. I forgot about that damn gas. You got 6 hot dog kids. You're like, can we get one? You should have been in there. You didn't help me count the turns. You don't get no hot dog. Fat people are never unhappy. We ain't never happy. Skinny people are unhappy. You see them at the fast food restaurant. They on their cheat day.
I really want some. I really want to eat something bad today. This is my cheat day. I really want something. I really want a double cheeseburger. If I get the double cheeseburger, I ain't going to be able to get the fries. But if I get the fries, I won't be able to get the chocolate shake. And they love that chocolate shake. Oh, I'm so confused. I don't know what I want, sir. You can go ahead of me.
Good, bitch. Move out of the way. Yeah. Yeah, give me a double cheeseburger. Everything on that, bitch. And a triple cheeseburger the same way. Give me a large fry. Put cheese on that something, bitch. And a large chocolate shake. Shit, put cheese on that, bitch. Give me something to drink, too. I'll take a Diet Coke. Yeah, put cheese on that shit. And I hate when you eat, you know, the only problem with eating bad is you always eat around something, bitch. They always want the so-called self-proclaimed nutritionist.
You gonna eat all that food and go to sleep?
Yes. That's what you do when you're sleepy. You go to sleep.
And you gonna wake up dead.
What kind of stupid ass shit is that? Who the hell you know wake up dead? When you dead, you don't wake the fuck up. That's how you know you dead. Like, oh, he up, he dead. Dumb man, I ain't never heard nobody wake up dead like you. Like, hello? Hello? Oh my God, she was right. I woke up dead. Worried about shit ain't none of our business.
You see what Donald Trump did today?
I don't give a shit with Donald Trump today. We the safest country on the planet right now because we got the most ignorant president ever. That's one thing you gotta look at. It ain't been no thought of terrorism. It ain't been no, we ain't heard nothing from the Taliban or Korea. They like, shit, I ain't going over there. You see who they got in their office? They got crazy some business opening it up. Let them be, man. We good, man. We gonna just blow up people in our country. We good. Ain't nobody doing shit right now. He done made it safe. He done made it safe, and gas is $1.94. Yeah. I ain't talking good about them. Only people booing ain't got no cars. Yeah. Shit, I loved Obama, but when he was in office, gas was $4.96 where I was. I said, get your black ass out of that damn office. I can't go nowhere with your black ass in that office. You fucking up, Obama, you fucking up. I loved Obama. I loved him the first time. I loved Obama the first term. That second term, I was kind of ready for him to get out of there. Because we were getting fucked up on the regular with him. And he was getting fucked up so bad, shit. I was scared. You had to play dead just to be around the police. You know shit bad when you got to wear a family reunion shirt to say your life matters. I had to wear a shirt to say my life matter? That's some bullshit. I'm putting them shirts $25 a piece. Shit, what if my shirt is in the dryer right now? Skinhead, hey boy, what's wrong with you? Are you suicidal? I'm like, what you mean? Where your fucking shirt at? Is it spin cycle right now? You better get that damn shirt out or your ass is dead. You hear me? I go get my son's shirt on. It's so little and tight, it don't even say Black Lives. It just say Matters on that something. I was in fat tonight. I got up to like 550 pounds. Yeah, yeah. People go, ooh.
Because people always say shit, like, you better lose some weight, you gonna die fat. I'm like, what kind of stupid ass did he die fat? If I was fat before I died, I'm gonna be fat when I'm dead. I ain't worried about that. That's my pallbearers worried. They gonna have to carry my ass. Nothing but the ride. You dragging them. Let them go. Put them down. What the fuck you mean we dragging them? We gotta drag. You see how heavy this son of a bitch is? Shit, why you had to die on my day off? Shit. Ooh-wee. Look at that program. Make sure my name on that shit. Don't look at me like that, Pastor. You ain't even help carrying. You walking with your Bible, ain't doing shit for it. Call on the Lord, because we need some more help now. Where we got to take this body anyway? Up them steps? Bullshit. Everybody come on down. Come on down. I ain't got no more sick days. Come on. He didn't walk up the steps when he was alive. And I ain't had no problem being big. I used to be fat denial, though, for real. I didn't even think of that damn big. I used to watch this show, My 600-Pound Life, for real, while eating my dinner, judging like a son of a bitch. Like, now, there's some fat motherfuckers on there. If I look like that, I get my shit together. And I finished eating, walked past the mirror like, oh my God, I'm gonna be on next season. But that show is bullshit. Cause they try to portray fat people as unhappy. Fat people are not unhappy. There's no truth in that. They are not unhappy. We are happy people. For real, food is our drug. We are not unhappy. We are unhappy. We eat us a Cinnabon, eat us some Bluebell ice cream. We be high. You skinny people the one unhappy. Y'all popping Molly, doing Percocet, sipping on syrup, smoking lace-ass marijuana, make your ass. Wake up, you done gave a dog a blowjob. Cinnabon ain't never made me blow a dog. Unless he was made of Cinnabon. Then I weigh it up. Is it fresh?